Hello and welcome to a new video. So here I will explain and compare the hypertrophic scar and the keloid. And here we have pictures of the hypertrophic scar here and here, and here pictures of the keloid as shown here and here and here. So both of these scars form due to excess collagen deposition during wound healing. Regarding the hypertrophic scar, it is a raised scar that don't grow beyond the boundaries of the original wound. So it's basically a raised scar and it is limited by the boundaries of the wound. It doesn't grow any more than these boundaries. It is maybe associated with itchiness and pain, and it develops due to trauma, wounds, cuts, burns, etc. The hypertrophic scar ranges in color from red to brown, and it develops 4 weeks after the injury and continues to thicken for up to 6 months, and it often regresses in 1 or 2 years. So it develops after 4 weeks after the injury and thicken up to 6 months, and then regresses in 1 or 2 years. The hypertrophic scar forms tension and flexor areas and restrict movement if they are located near a joint. So if the hypertrophic scar is near a joint, the joint movement would be restricted. And the treatment using cryosurgery and silicone sheeting may be helpful, but not always. Now regarding the keloid scar, the keloid scar is a firm, rubbery lesion or shiny fibrous nodule that can be sometimes itchy and painful. So this is an example of the keloid. It is on the auricle of the ear. It is shiny, as we can see, and it also has dark brown color, and it sometimes can be itchy and painful. It forms because of the injury or a wound, and usually after 3 months, 2 years of the initial insult, but sometimes arises spontaneously. So it forms after 3 months, 2 years after the insult, and sometimes arises spontaneously without any injury whatsoever. It has autosomal dominant predisposition. The keloid scar extends beyond the original wound. Now, we mentioned with the hypertrophic scar, it is limited to the boundaries of the wound, but the keloid is the opposite. It would extend beyond the original wound. And the color varies from pink to dark brown, and it rarely regresses spontaneously, and the keloid scar is benign. And as we can see in this picture, we have multiple keloid scars on the upper torso. The keloid scar needs multimodal approach of treatment: surgical excision, steroids, silicone sheeting, and cryosurgery, and many other modalities. Now here we have a table comparing them. So regarding the size, the hypertrophic scar stays within the initial wound boundaries, and the keloid goes beyond the initial wound boundaries. The onset, the hypertrophic scar develops 4 weeks after the injury and continues to thicken for up to 6 months. The keloid forms after 3 months, 2 years of the initial insult, and grows over time. Now regarding the offset, the hypertrophic scar shrinks after a year and the keloid don't shrink at all. Effects on joint movement: the hypertrophic scar restricts joint movement, the keloid don't restrict the joint movement at all. And regarding incidence, the hypertrophic scar is more common while the keloid is less common. And regarding the location, the hypertrophic scar grows anywhere in the body where the wound is. And the keloid commonly develops on the upper torso and the earlobes and cheeks. And with that, we reach the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe. And if you want to support us more, you can by subscribing to the Patreon. Link provided in the description of this video. Thank you for watching and peace.